السلام عليكم ورحمة الله تعالى وبركاته. May Allah سبحانه وتعالى accept إن شاء الله all of our good deeds and may Allah سبحانه وتعالى protect our, all of our nation, society, Muslim families, Muslim أمة يا رب العالمين from any kind of harm and any kind of sickness and may Allah سبحانه وتعالى cover us all with His رحمة and mercy and tranquility يا رب العالمين. سبحان الله nowadays you see too many people they are talking about the how to protect yourself from coronavirus. And subhanAllah, people always, they are talking about that in the social media everywhere. But if you see in general around the world now, the world like in quarantine. Actually, all the whole entire world in quarantine. Everybody sitting home. People, they are frightened, scared. And because of that corona, not really from corona, from death. They are scaring from death. Nobody wanna die. But today I wanna focus about something very important. I get a question yesterday from Washington DC and another question from Mecca. Somebody called me through the WhatsApp and asking me about something, يعني, subhanAllah. One of them was talking like almost 15 minutes talking about something very important and subhanAllah, Jazallah khair. He يعني opened my mind for this point. I'm talking about it right now. Everybody now, subhanAllah, with the coronavirus, he's trying to clean his hand. And subhanAllah, and mashallah, all doctors, the one he knows and the one who don't know on the social media, everybody's talking about hand sanitizer, soap, water, and make it like this, and make it like this, and make it like this, like this. And like this, and the barajim, and the clean, and everybody, mashallah, talking about that يعني very much. Why? To avoid the coronavirus. Subhanallah, which is not bad, I'm not saying anything. That's called, they call that in Arabic, nazafa. Nazafa means cleanliness. But we forget about something very important. Not nazafa, not cleanliness. We forget about something called purification. Purification. Tahara, not nazafa. Nazafa, cleanliness. When you clean this, I have something comes in my clothes, I want to clean it. This is called nazafa, nazif, I'm nazif, I'm clean. Okay, but purification, in general, tahara, very strong word. Purification is different because nazafa, just to clean your body from outside, to clean your hand, to take shower, to make wudu, which is good, is not bad. Muslim and a mu'min must be clean. But the purification means outside and before inside. And that very important point, as I said, the corona or any kind of sickness, it's ibtila min Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It's a test from Allah for the believers, for the mu'mineen, for the muslimin. And it's a punishment for others. I did not mean non-Muslim, no. For those who are disobeying Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, even they are Muslims. Anybody away, astray from Allah, is disobeying Allah. Corona, it's a punishment for them. It is not a test, only a test for the believers. My point today, it is not the cleanliness of your hand. You want to protect yourself from Corona? You have to clean inside first. To clean your heart from what? Any kind of illness. There are too many sickness and illness of the hearts. Amrad al-Qulub, they call it. To clean your heart from the envy, the hatred, the jealousy, from the robbery, from rishwa, from lying, from backbiting, slandering people, killing people, being harsh, being bad. There are too many things, and bless all of that. And that brother, when he talked to me from Mecca, wallahi, subhanAllah, was telling me, talking about something very important. The السحر. How people until now, they are affecting somebody's life by السحر, the magic. Magic. Imagine that somebody, everybody's crying from coronavirus and somebody's going to the fortune teller and the ساحر to hurt somebody to make his life upside down. And Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم said, السحر كفر. It's a كفر. It's a kufr 100%, one word. If you go to the sahir, the magician, to let him use his jinn to make somebody's life upside down, to separate his family, to separate his wife from him or his husband, her husband, and to make somebody sick or somebody. This is harm. There is no benefit from magic. It's all harm. Islam said that. Allah said in the Holy Quran, وَاتَّبَعُوا مَا تَتْلُوا الشَّيَاطِينُ عَلَى مُلْكِ سُلَيْمَانُ وَمَا كَفَرَ سُلَيْمَانُ. Sulaiman was not kafir, Prophet Solomon. وَلَكِنَّ الشَّيَاطِينَ كَفَرُ. But the shayateen, they were kuffar. Why? Allah said, يُعَلِّمُونَ النَّاسَ السِّحْرِ. Because they used to teach people magic, sihr. وَمَا أُنزِلَ عَلَى الْمَلَكَيْنِ بَابِلَ هَارُوتَ وَمَارُوتَ. وَمَا يُعَلِّمَانِ مِنْ أَحَدٍ حَتَّى يَقُولَ إِنَّمَا نَحْنُ فِتْنَةٌ فَلَا تَكْفُرْ. What they are doing? فَيَتَعَلَّمُونَ مِنْ هُوَ مَا يُفَرِّقُونَ بِهِ بَيْنَ الْمَرْءِ وَزَوْجِهِ. They learn from الشياطين what to separate a man from his wife, to separate the family, to break the family. And it is not easy. It is not easy. This is so difficult to take that away from people, that magic or that harm. It's not easy. Do you know, imagine, yani barely I'm walking myself. Sometimes if I feel dizzy, sometimes I'm tired. Imagine if somebody's riding your shoulder while you're eating, sleeping, walking, working, all of your daily life, your activities, somebody riding your shoulder. This is jinn. It's riding your hair. Huh? Subhanallah. Yani imagine that, it's telling you what to do. He's making your life upside down. Somebody they send like jinn, lover jinn, somebody they send some jinn to separate the family, to harm somebody in his body. Yes, there are too many stories. But the point here is, yani, how we as Muslims, now I call myself Muslim and you call yourself Muslim, you are accepting that for somebody. Now you have to test that. Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sending that coronavirus, imagine that coronavirus comes or goes directly to somebody's lungs. It's going directly like this to your lungs. Gonna destroy you. You cannot breathe. This is the way you are harming others. For Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is telling us stop. Now you have, everybody must make tawbah. You have to ask Allah for his forgiveness. You ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for tawbah, repentance, and sincere repentance. Don't harm people. Because Islam said that, لا ضرر ولا ضرار. You cannot harm anybody. Don't harm even yourself. Allah said, لا تخو ولا تقتلوا أنفسكم. Do not kill your own selves. إن الله كان بكم رحيم. From this point, before you clean your hand, from corona, clean your heart. Don't lie anymore. Don't backbite anymore. Don't slander people. Don't talk about these women. Don't talk about that man. Don't take the money of people. Don't cheat people. Don't betray people. Robbery, rishwat. Don't take rishwa. Don't make mischief. Don't harm others. That's why the harm can come to you. I read one hadith, subhanAllah. That hadith I was explaining yesterday, hadith narrated by Abu in the Tirmizi, Imam al-Tirmizi, he mentioned that in his Sahih. And Abu Huraira, I think Mu'adh ibn Jabal, both they narrated that hadith. I mentioned it yesterday. تَقِ اللَّهَ حَيْثُمَا كُنْتُ. Fear Allah wherever you will be. You are outside, inside your bedroom, outside your... Fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. اتق الله حيثما كنت. Wherever you will be, fear Allah. As much as you can, try. We are human. I'm not saying we are angels. I know we are making mistakes. But Allah is all forgiving, Rahim. Turn your face to Him. Ask Him for tawbah. And this is the time of tawbah. اتق الله حيثما كنت. Wherever you will be, fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And follow the sin with hasana. I said that yesterday, explain it for 30 minutes. Whenever you make sin, follow حسنة, follow to حسنة, follow up it out. Make good deeds. وخلق الناس بخلق حسن. You have to deal with people with good manners and good أخلاق. And to have that good manners and good أخلاق, والله you're gonna be the neighbor of Rasulullah in Jannah. When you have this good conduct and good manners and good أخلاق, when you deal with others. Allah سبحانه وتعالى, when he talks about Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم, in the Holy Quran, in Surah Ali Imran, look how the Sahaba disobeyed Rasulullah in the Battle of Uhud. And he was about to be killed because of them. Because of the Sahaba. Because they make a big mistake. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgive them. Allah opened the door for them. Even Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, don't be harsh with him. Because what he said, وَلَوْ كُنْتَ فَضًّا غَلِيظَ الْقَلْبِ لَنْفَضُّ مِنْ حَوْلِكَ. Oh Muhammad, if you are harsh with them, they will run away from you. فَعْفُ عَنْهُمْ, pardon them, forgive them. وَاسْتَغْفِرْ لَهُمْ, ask Allah forgiveness for them too. وَشَاوِرْهُمْ فِي الْأَمْرِ, consult with them again. Because he did consult with them before, and they said very bad opinion, and that's why. See, for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, Rasul, do it again, don't worry, don't do it again. Ask Allah forgiveness for them. Be nice, be gentle to them, don't be harsh. This is a way. احنا, ya jama'a, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will not help us if we will not be good inside. You have to be good inside. You have to purify this area. First, before you clean your hand. I know you're gonna clean your hand, you're gonna clean your face, you're gonna clean your nose, your mouth, and we're making wudu, but the king of your body, your heart, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said that. أَلَا إِنَّ فِي الْجَسَدِ مُضْغَةِ إِذَا صَرُحَتْ صَرُحَ الْجَسَدِ. That part, organ in your body, your heart, the king of your body, if it is good, all the body is good, mashallah. The king is salih, pious, all the ra'iyya, the followers, they are good people. They're gonna be good. The same in your body. The king of your body, your heart. You have your body. Allah doesn't care about your body. You're tall or short or fat or whatever. Your skin, whatever. Allah doesn't care about this. You have your own soul. Soul three types. Actually, seven types. نفس الخبيثة والمطمئنة واللوامة والرضية والمرضية والملهمة سبحان الله والكاملة. This is the anfus. Your soul, too many types. And your spirit, your روح. الروح nobody knows about it except Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah said in the Quran, ويسألونك عن الروح. They ask you about الروح, your spirit. قل الروح من أمر ربي. The one he knows about its affairs, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It's not your business. Without الروح, your body gonna be like this. Nothing. Cannot, gonna be nothing. No. الروح is a power inside your body. When the روح goes out, خلاص, that's it, you're dying. And the main thing in your body, still your brain also is nothing. It's important to control everything, managing. Somehow everything must go through your brain. But from where the source, the main one, the heart. If your heart is good, the brain will take right order and they give order to the body like this. If the heart is kharban, they're gonna be wrong orders. All bad orders to the brain, and the brain just following the order of the heart, because the heart is a king. The heart is a king. That's why you have to purify this first. Before you purify your hand, sanitizer, soap, and everybody in social media, coronavirus, eat this, don't eat that, take that, and don't don't deal with people, be like 2 meters away from everybody, and مش عارف ايه coronavirus. طيب, we're not talking about your heart. Purify this. That's why Rasulullah said, At-tuhur, the purification, is half of your iman. Very important. Don't harm anybody. Ask Allah for tawbah. The one he used to drink al-khamr, stop. Don't drink alcohol anymore. The one who used to make adultery, stop. Don't make it anymore. We are in the time, very bad time now. The qiyamah is coming. The day of judgment is coming. And you don't have to do it for the day of judgment. Since you die, this is the day of judgment for you. Since you die, you are there already under Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. At Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That's why, dear brothers, this advice does not mean coronavirus is here. You're not coming to the masjid. We are like 6, 7 people today in Salat al-Fajr. I'm sad. I know the masjid must be closed. I know coronavirus, I know. Why I agree 100%. But we're still less than 10. We are 5, 4, it's okay. But the point here is, don't be happy because you're not coming to the masjid and you have an excuse. No, you have to have a masjid in your house. Nowadays, take fatwa from me. It's a fatwa from Sayyid Jum'ah to all entire the world, all Muslim ummah. You have to have a masjid in your house. This is what Allah said. And Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said that to the Sahaba, that masjid not for the farida. Usually, during the normal time, that masjid must be. Masjid means you're gonna get carpet, a special place, nobody allowed to go there in the corner of the house. This is for the prayer, for you and the whole entire family. And this is called musalla or masjid, small masjid in the corner of your house. Yeah. What for nawafil, for qiyam al-layl, for tahajjud? Now you're not coming to the masjid for a reason. Yes, we agree. Yes. Keep yourself away. Be careful. We don't need anybody to be sick. We're asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for safety for all the human being. Yes. Stay at home, not watching TV, playing your cellular phone, wasting time, because I have an excuse not to go to the masjid. Brothers, we need tawbah. We need everybody to turn his face to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Sisters, yes, stop do the bad things and pray at home. Make tahajjud, make general tawbah to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Ask Allah, ya Rab, to take this away from us. Huh? Make the du'as, make the zikr. Bismillah, tawakkaltu ala Allah wa la hawla wa quwwata illa billah. Eat dates, huh? But olive oil, olive that black seed oil or black seed, that's a very important one for coronavirus. We are reading in the internet. Yes, all of that, subhanAllah, vitamin C, very important. Make your immune system strong. And one reason, nobody talk about this point, to make your immune system strong, to connect yourself to Allah. Wallahi al-azim, this is very important point. Wallahi, when you have that shakina, calm down, and you're relaxing, because your heart attached to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, means your immune system and your body will be in the same direction. Yes, if you have confusion in your heart and your brain, you have fear, you're not strong enough, your immune system gonna be like this. Do you know like what? Brother Chance is talking to me, Brother Siddiqui is talking to me, Brother Hamid is talking to me, Brother Qasim, they are talking to me in the same time. I gotta be in confusion. I said, what? I cannot understand all of you in the same time. This is the immune system. If you make your immune system busy with too many things, and the immune system must be ready for the corona. Yes, don't, al-mashghul la yushghal. If somebody busy, don't make him busy. This is the point of the immune system. How to make your immune system strong? Come to Allah, make sujood, make ruku'ah, make zikr, subhanallah. That will empower you, wallahi al-azim. And the most, istighfar. Quran said that. Sayyidina Hud, Prophet Hud, was advising his people. And they said, وَيَقَوْمِ اسْتَغْفِرُوا رَبَّكُمْ ثُمَّ تُوبُوا إِلَيْهِ. Oh my people, seek forgiveness from Allah and make tawbah to Allah. Repent to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. قَدْ يُرْسِلِ السَّمَاءَ عَلَيْكُمْ مِدْرَارًا will send rain abundant, a lot of rain to you. Huh? وَيَزِدُكُمْ قُوَّةً إِلَىٰ قُوَّتِكُمْ. And you are strong, he will increase. He will give you extra, more power. فالاستغفار will empower you. استغفر الله وأتوب إليه. استغفر الله from the minor sins وأتوب إليه from the سيئات, from the major ones. سبحان الله. This is how Muslim Ummah must do. Turn your face to Allah. Don't harm anybody anymore. Because any second, see what's going on in Italy? China, they are in the top for those who get the coronavirus. Thousands of people, they die. Don't listen to the media. Too many people die. Yeah, be aware. After that, Italy, I think after China, yes. After that, maybe France or Germany or Spain, all of this. America too, one of them, subhanAllah. Yes, maybe like 19,000 people until now from in America, they have the sickness. Too many, they die too. فجماعه, everywhere around the world, it's a global epidemic, يعني وباء عالمي, around the world, يعني. فأنت, imagine that, you are harming people, you are hurting somebody. Imagine that the coronavirus will go direct. Allah will send him, he's one of the soldiers of Allah. Direct to your heart, to your lungs, where you breathe, you cannot breathe anymore. You have money, you have time, you have power to go around the world. But you cannot. You are in quarantine now. You have to stay home. Who gave that order to you? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. To everybody around them. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Did you see in Iran? Iran, yes, Iran after Italy, I think. Did you see in Iran how they bury people? They buried them. They put them in the grave yesterday. They carried a man in the same grave, big grave for everybody. Like ta'un, we are in the plague. It's a plague. And they carry him with like wires like this, ropes. And they make him like this. They throw him like you throw something like that in the grave, above each other's like this. Yeah. This is in Iran because they are still Muslims. What about in Italy? I saw Egyptian guy yesterday, in young guy, like in 30s. He lives in Italy, crying. Do you know why he's crying? He's crying not because he's gonna die or coronavirus. He's crying because in Italy they said, maybe we cannot bury you. Maybe we'll burn your body. That's why the man is crying. He cannot go to Egypt. He cannot get out. And he's scared from what? Burning his body. He's Muslim. And in Islam, you cannot burn somebody's body. And there is no dignity. خلاص, it's a plague, and you have to get rid of this. Because this is sickness. This is can infect others, you know? The infection can come to others from him. Adwa, you know? That's why, just get rid of him. Burn his body. Let him go away. Yeah, they have to bury him. Subhanallah. أحيانا بحطوا جير وحاجات كده عليه عشان العدوى. ف يا جماعة والله يا جماعة we have to think about everything around us. It is not just the corona and you're gonna sit home and that's it. No, turn your face to Allah. Allah the one who created coronavirus and everything in his قبل and his feast. كن فيكون. We learn that from the Quran الكريم. Purify your heart. Don't harm people. Please don't harm people. Don't make magic. جادو. Don't make anything to anybody. Think. Use this, Allah give you the brain. Purify your heart and use this because you have to be a wise, people. You have to be wise people. You have to be wise people. Use your wisdom if you have wisdom. Haram, because Allah, those who called me, they've been crying. They've been hurt by people. The hurt can come to me and can come to you. May Allah save all of us and give us all recovery. Ameen ya Rabbil Ameen. May Allah cover us inshallah and give us all speed recovery for those who are sick and give us shifa ya Rabbil Ameen. Rabbana taqabbal minna wa aghfir lana warhamna wa ahdina wa asturna wa ahfazna ya Rabbil Ameen. Yassir lana umarana yamil lana kitabana wa ahfazna jami'an min bayna idina wa min khalfina wa an aymanina wa an shamilna wa ajalna laka minash shakirin ya Arhamar Rahimin. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect the humanity, the all human beings ya Rabbil Ameen, the society, nations, Muslims and non-Muslims, everybody from Corona and from any kind of illness, Ya Rahman Rahimeen. We're asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for safety. Allah, Ya Rabbil Alameen. Save us, Ya Rabbil Alameen. Ya Allah, Rabbil Alameen. Protect us, Ya Rahman Rahimeen. You are the Lord of all mankind. You are Rabbil Nas, Ya Rahman Rahimeen. Ighfir lana wa rahamna wa asturna. Wa sallallahu alayhi wa sallam wa alayhi wa sallam. Jazakum Allah khairan.